Hello, my lovely friends. My name is Ava, and here are some romances with alpha heroes. I know I've said before on my channel that I prefer like a sweeter hero, but don't get me wrong, that doesn't mean that I can't also appreciate a good alpha man, okay? I have a bunch of recommendations on my channel for alpha heroes. I'll link them all down below if you're interested in more recommendations. But without further ado, here are 10 more romance recs with alpha heroes in them. Obviously, Alex from Twisted Love is a great choice for an alpha hero. He has been tasked by his best friend to watch over his little sister for him, who is Ava. Alex is a very grumpy man, and he doesn't really want to watch over Ava, but he can't help like follow his best friend's instructions. He's like, okay, if he's telling me to take care of his little sister and watch over her, like I'm gonna go all in, even if it makes Ava like completely frustrated because she doesn't think that she needs a babysitter. She's in college, by the way. Alex basically moves in right next door to watch over her, and she's not happy. She decides to try and make Alex tick in whatever way possible because he's very stoic and stone-faced. She's like, okay, I'm gonna try and get any emotion out of him. So that's kind of like her goal, to make him express any emotion, okay? Alex is also hiding a few secrets, and Ava is determined to figure out what those secrets are, but she might not like what they are, just saying. So Alex is definitely an alpha man. Next is Scarred by Emily McIntyre. It's part of her like villains series. So she has basically created romances where the heroine gets with the Disney tale villain instead of the hero. So our heroine in here, her name is Sarah, or Sarabi, okay, from The Lion King, and she gets with good old Scar here. Okay, so Scar is the younger brother to our Mufasa character, and he has decided to make his brother's life a living hell, even if that means taking his brother's fiance, because he doesn't think that his brother is worth like having a title becoming king. So he's gonna take Sarah as his own and lure her in every way possible. One of the most alpha heroes that I've read is definitely our hero in here. Man, he makes like the heroine like literally crawl on her knees to him. If you want more of a paranormal one, I have The Tyrant Alpha's Rejected Mate by Kate C. Wells. Literally alpha's in the title. Our hero is the alpha of this werewolf pack, and the heroine Una comes up to him one day. She's very weak and small compared to other wolf shifters in the pack. And she basically tells him like, I think you're my fated mate. And he's like, no, you're not. I would be able to tell if you are. So I reject you. Like, you're obviously not my fated mate, but they are mates. And she basically runs off into the woods after his rejection. And she's in so much pain, like physically, like the wolf inside of her is like being rejected, and it hurts so bad that she forces like the pack witch to turn off and remove the mating bond. So she does that, and the hero quickly realizes, I messed up. I actually think that she is my mate, and decides to start groveling his bootay off. Oh my gosh, if you hear something, my dad has a blowtorch out. That's what that sound is. So he's gonna get the heroine back by any means possible. He's very alpha, very alpha of him. If you want more of a shorter read, I have Hold by Claire Kent. So this one is a sci-fi read, but there's no aliens. So if you're not into aliens, like this one doesn't deal with aliens. It just deals with like other planets. So our heroine is a researcher, and she was sent to study something on a planet, not knowing that it's actually illegal to do that on the planet. Like, no one told her. She gets in trouble with like the space government, and they end up putting her in jail. Into this jail that is literally like a planet that is entirely water, and they have built jail cells underneath the water so no one like can escape. And so she gets put into one of those jails, and the person, the warden, like putting her in, is like, you better find the biggest man in there and offer yourself to him for protection, or you're gonna like die. Like, they're gonna rip you apart. So she does just that. She finds the man who has his own cell, who is ginormous, and is like, I will literally do anything for you. Like, make sure no one kills me. And so that's kind of how their romance starts. It is pretty short, so be aware of that, but it's actually like a really fun read and definitely unique, because I've never like read about something like an underwater prison, because the two of them also like figure out like, we have to escape, like let's do it. So they plan an escape at the same time too. Next, I have one of my favorite reads. This is Broken by the Horde King by Zoe Draven. This is book number 4 in her Horde Kings of Dakar series. It's one of my favorite books of all time. I love it so much. So this one takes place on a planet called Dakar, where there are natives to the planet called the Dakari, who basically look like humans. They just have gold skin, different color eyes. They have a tail also. And they're kind of like barbarian esque. Like they wear like loincloths and stuff like that. So our heroine actually grew up in one of the villages, but she's a human. One of the soldiers watching over the Dakari village ends up across her at a very young age, like abandoned in the forest, and saving her and adopting her as his own, like with his wife. So she is the only human living in this village. She becomes friends with kind of like the prince of the village, who's our hero. They become best friends. They've been like in each other's lives for years. They can count on each other for literally anything. And there comes a point when the hero becomes of age, and so does the heroine, and she basically tells him her feelings, and he publicly rejects her, and it is absolutely awful. And the hero has gone off to make a name of himself and become a horde king, and he comes back years later and is determined to win this woman back and to make her the healer of his own horde and village. But she is not going to just say yes so easily, because he absolutely wrecked her heart. There's like other things in here too to make her not want to say yes, to make him grovel his butt off. But basically this whole book is him groveling, which y'all know I love a good grovel, love it. He's this big, definite alpha man, okay? Even though he's groveling his butt off and like is on his knees at some points, he knows when to take control, just saying. Ruby Dixon writes a lot of like sweet cinnamon roll heroes, but she also writes some good alpha men. So here are two for you. First is Bad Guy by Ruby Dixon. This book starts out so good. I love this one. Okay, so this one is about Cruelden. And he is this very well-known like gladiator warrior dude who like is kind of like a slave though. Like he is forced to go out into rings and kill other creatures. And he basically wakes up kind of like with amnesia in this jail cell, not knowing how he got there. He is not very happy about the situation, doesn't know where he is. He's very confused, very angry. He ends up like tearing apart his cell, ripping the sink out of the wall, like ripping up the sheets and everything. Someone is sent in to clean up his mess. And so he has these cuffs on his wrists and ankles, and he gets magnetized to the wall. He can't move from the wall. And in walks this very tiny, as you can see, this very tiny human woman. I think her name's Mina. And she is sent to clean up his mess. She is a human slave, and that's basically her job, just to clean up cells. And she takes one look at him after she cleans up his mess and is like, don't do that again, dude. Like, she's this tiny little human woman talking to this big, like, scary looking alien. Is like, you better stop. Like, I don't want to clean this up again. And guess what he does for days and days after that, to just get a glimpse of this woman, like completely tear apart his cell. And there comes a point where he will agree to take part in some studies that these people have that they want to do on him. And he's like, okay, I'll agree to do some of this stuff if you give me Mina, because I want Mina. So very big, very big alpha man. There's obviously Whcih from Barbarian Alien, book number 2 in the Ice Planet Barbarian series. Whcih kidnaps Liz once he figures out that they're fated mates, and he will not let her go until she agrees to be his. So yeah, if you don't know the Ice Planet Barbarian series, human women crash land on this ice planet, and they have to get like these symbiote parasites put into their body to like help them live on the planet, or they would die. And these symbiotes also tell them and like will hum to them when their fated mate is near. And so he figures out that they're fated mates, and he's gonna make her hit. Okay. Next is The Beast by Jenica Snow, if you want a monster romance. And this is a Beauty and the Beast retelling where the Beast does not turn into a man. Like, he is the Beast the whole time. So the hero is our Beast character, and he has this big castle he lives in that he's been cursed with, okay? And he goes to the village nearby to just like people watch at times, and he becomes very entranced by our Belle character. And he has decided, like, I'm going to make this woman mine. Let me figure out how to do that. So he ends up finding out that her dad is in debt with some bad guys, and then he forces him to kind of like become in debt with him, to a point where this man ends up selling his daughter to the Beast. And things happen, okay? It's very, very typical Beauty and the Beast retelling, okay? But it's hotter, spicier, and more monster-esque. So this man literally like stalks our heroine, forces her to be sold to him, and like takes control in every way possible. An alien read that I have with like no like alien creatures, they both basically look like humans, but they're from different planets, is Claiming His Virgin by Grace Goodwin. This is one of the few Grace Goodwin books that like is really, really, really good to me. A lot of her books are very similar. This one I feel like stands out. It is shorter in length, but I feel like it's totally worth it. So our hero in here, he is a kind of like war veteran and from this like space war, and he finds out that he has a fated mate that is like genetically matched to him, who is our heroine, and he decides to send her a message to like meet up one day because she's on his planet now. And he asks her to wear a blindfold when they first meet, and a few other times after they meet, because he's terrified that this woman will be scared of him because he actually has a lot of scars on his face and on his body from, I think, like an explosion when he was at war, and he does not want to scare his mate whatsoever. But with her like being blindfolded, he commands her in like every way possible, and it is really hot. It's really hot. And my last recommendation is a novella. This is Caught by the Convicts by Jessa Kane. Our heroine was abused by her dad for years. He's in jail now, but she's not like fully believing, like she can't sleep at night until she sees him behind bars. And so she goes to the jail cell. The warden is like walking her through to show her where her father is when there is like a jail break. And these two men in a cell who recently saw her end up saving her, bringing her into their cell, keeping her protected from all the other men that are running rampant in the jail, right? And she kind of spends a little bit of time with these two men. So it's an MFM novella read. And there is one of the men that like dominates both of them. And it's really fun. It's really fun. So if you want like a short, quick read, definitely recommend this one by Jessa Kane. I'm so sad that Jessa Kane's not coming out with more books because I need more. And I don't want to read her backlist because then I'm going to be done with her backlist and there's not going to be any more. I'm just really hoping that she either has another pen name out there and is still writing some more like bonkers books. Anyways, there you have it. Those are some romances with alpha men in them. Let me know down below if you read any of these books or if you plan to. But if you don't feel like commenting any of those things, you can leave me what emoji? Let's do a turtle emoji in the comment section down below. But anyways, thank y'all so much for watching. I will see y'all soon in my next one. Bye y'all.